Experts, meantime, weighing in after attorneys general across the nation, including right here in Colorado, filing a lawsuit against Facebook's parent company, Meta. So this is part of an effort to hold social media companies accountable for the addictiveness of their apps. Channel 2's Samantha Spitz is on it tonight with both sides. New at 7.
Colorado, along with dozens of other states, are suing Meta, alleging their social media platforms are addictive and harmful to kids.
I do think it has merit.
Randy Smith, a professor in the Department of Psychological Sciences at MSU Denver, says there's been warnings for several years about the dangers of social media, pointing to the latest advisory issued by the U.S. Surgeon General.
The software are very intentionally designed to keep all of us hooked. The use of algorithms, the tracking of our behavior, the infinite scroll, all these things prey on our own sort of cognitive shortcomings and can pull us in.
Meta released a statement in response to the allegations, saying in part, "We share the Attorney General's commitment to providing teens with safe, positive experiences online and have already introduced over 30 tools to support teens and their families. We're disappointed that instead of working productively with companies across the industry to create clear, age-appropriate standards for the many apps teens use, the attorney generals have chosen this path." The lawsuit claims the tech giant's strategy violates the Federal Children's Online Privacy Protection Act and argues the platform features have fueled a youth mental health crisis. A Meta spokesperson addressed these claims, assuring the company prohibits users under the age of 13 on Instagram and does not knowingly collect information from anyone under 13. They add the company prompts teens to take time away from these apps with their Take a Break feature. But to some degree, Smith says these companies need to be held accountable.
I also think that parents and other caregivers have a responsibility to help guide young people. I think we all have an opportunity to talk more about the influences of social media and to help young people learn about, you know, media literacy, that what they're reading and seeing and consuming isn't the entire picture.
In Denver, Samantha Spitz, 2 Prime News.